Hello and welcome to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, and today I am joined by Sean Hillacre, the VP of Exploration at Standard Uranium. Sean, thanks for joining me.
No problem, Natalie. Pleasure to be here.
Fabulous. Sean, let's dive into some big, very technical news coming out from Standard Uranium. The final analytical results from the summer drill program have just been released. Can you summarize those results for me and put it into layman terms just because of how technical it is?
Absolutely, Natalie. I mean, anytime we get geochemistry back, it's quite technical, but the kind of key things to pick up on in the release are, you know, the good signs we're seeing in the rocks and, you know, how that's going to help us find uranium on Davidson River. We talk about pathfinder elements a lot. That's basically a group of elements on the periodic table that are related to uranium and the fluid systems that uranium travel in. So that's what we look at. We look at if those levels in the rocks of those particular elements are elevated compared to, you know, basic normal background rocks, so to speak, and they are. So boron is an important one that we mentioned in the release, and also associated with elevated uranium in the rocks as well. So great signs that we're seeing in the rocks at Davidson River, and very promising results.
And from these results, how does that essentially tee up what 2023 could be looking like?
Great question. So, you know, like I said, these pathfinder elements, you know, they're aptly named. They show us the path to hopefully discover high-grade uranium mineralization on the project. So we use those as a vector to continue drilling on the project and continue exploring to hopefully narrow in on that uranium mineralization. So we have a big drill program planned for 2023 on the project, beginning early June and going through the summer. So we're going to get up there again with two drills, and we're going to continue following up on these results that we've seen, some of the best results that we've seen on the project. Each drill program we complete on Davidson has been better and better. We're seeing better and better signs that we're on the right path there. So very excited to get back up there in 2023. And these results, in conjunction with some other new things that we're doing, are going to define those drill targets for next year.
So it appears that some alteration zones have also popped up from this summer drill program. How does that also relate to the importance of the entirety of this program?
Great question. So alteration is a very key thing that we look for when we're searching for uranium deposits. These deposits typically have an alteration halo, so basically a zone around that mineralization where the rock is altered and changed. So uranium travels in these fluid systems with these pathfinder elements, and it alters the rock and changes it into different minerals such as clay. Dravite is one that you've heard me talk about before. So we're seeing zones of clay alteration, really good iron oxide alteration that we call like a redox front. That's in the news release as well. Very commonly associated with high-grade uranium in the Athabasca Basin. So all fantastic signs that, you know, fluids have been moving through these rocks, and these are the right types of fluids that we want to see. So not only that, but it also, you know, kind of plays into the structures in the basement. You can see in the news release, there's quite a few rock photos in there and some cross sections. So those structures are also very important because they channel those fluids through the rock and basically focus where the uranium could be going. So there's good evidence for really good fluid movement in the rocks and in the structures that we're seeing. And not only that, but in the geochemistry, there's also good evidence for uranium being actually scavenged from rocks in the area. So now we need to find out where it went. So that's the plan for next year.
Wow, so it really seems like there'll be lots of action for you guys at Standard Uranium for next year. But how does it also contribute to having a partnership with Goldspot, who essentially takes care of AI drill target generation, and how the plans for next year at Davidson River will look?
Yeah, it's a very cool thing that we're doing, actually. We're the first uranium company in the basin that Goldspot is partnered with. So we're working with their team of professional geoscientists and geophysicists. They have a really, really good team there of experts that we're working with. So what they're doing is basically taking all of these, you know, ingredients that we're looking for as far as geophysical surveys, and all of these layers kind of line up, and that makes a good drill target. So now Goldspot is taking that to the next level using their machine learning and artificial intelligence algorithms. So they kind of, you know, add to what, you know, myself as a geoscientist and our technical team can do and take that to the next level with computer and machine learning. So that's really going to help us, you know, define and prioritize our drill targets for next year in conjunction with those, you know, the vectors that we were talking about that we already have. So it's just going to be another layer of data for us to use and vector into that discovery. So really excited to be working with them. Some really exciting preliminary results also coming out with them so far. So I'm really excited to share that in the future. And yeah, we're really excited to get back up there and get the drill spinning.
And we look forward to hearing more updates from you guys at Standard Uranium. So best of luck at Davidson River. Thank you so much for joining me, Sean, and we'll see you again soon.
Sounds good, Natalie. Thanks for having me.